Hello students, let us start with our new online lecture for the course title Horticulture 243. So today's topic is cultivation of pineapple, cultivation practices for pineapple. So let us see about pineapple cultivation practices. Start with its botanical description. Pineapple, its botanical name of pineapple is Ananas comosus. Botanical name for pineapple is Ananas comosus. It belongs to the family Bromeliaceae, and the chromosome number for ananas is 2N is equal to 28. Now let us move on to the next slide for ananas cultivation. The importance of ananas. Pineapple is considered as one of the most popular tropical fruit and is also known as golden queen all over the globe. That means it is recognized as golden queen all over the world. It can be grown as a mixed crop in most of the orchards. It is a drought tolerant and suitable for marginal lands. Marginal lands means those farmers having small lands. Small lands, that means below 5 acres of lands. It is suitable for such marginal lands or marginal farmers. Pineapple is rich source of vitamin A, B and also calcium. It contains major compound called bromelain. This is the major compound present in ananas, that is bromelain. It is a native of Brazil and grown in Philippines, Australia, South Africa and Singapore. That means the very wild ancestors of this ananas or pineapple has been found in Brazil, but it is grown all over other countries like Philippines, Australia and South Africa and Singapore. In India, it is grown in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar and Assam. And in relation to Maharashtra, it is grown in some pockets of Konkan region. Regarding the climatic and soil requirement of this crop, pineapple can be grown successfully from sea coast to an altitude or height of about 1500 meters above mean sea level. The optimum temperature requirement for this crop is 21 to 24 degrees centigrade. Now it can be also grown in areas where the temperature ranges from 22 degrees centigrade to 32 degrees centigrade with optimum rainfall from 100 to 150 centimeters. The higher temperature is beneficial for fruit development, whereas low temperature is harmful and does not improve color of the fruits. That means it favors high temperature, whereas low temperatures are harmful and quality also deteriorates. Does not improve color of the fruits. That means we cannot get good color fruits. Soil requirement of this crop is the fruits grows well in sandy loam soils. Fruit size is larger on heavier soils, but flavor of fruit is better when grown on lighter soils. That means lighter soils favors the various qualities of fruits, that is color, taste, size, etc. But heavier soils favor only size, not the flavor of the fruits. It prefers the soils which are slightly acidic. That means pH ranging from 4.5 to 5.5, while high magnesium and manganese content are injurious to this crop. That means high manganese and magnesium content in the soil are injurious to pineapple cultivation. Now, these are some of the species of ananas. Especially there are 6 species which we are studying is the first one, that is Ananas comosus. Now, the next species here you can see in the slide is Ananas bracteatus. Ananas bracteatus. The third one is Ananasioides. The fourth one is Ananas nansus. The fifth one is Ananas parguazensis. And the last one is Ananas lucidus. The most commonly cultivated species is Ananas comosus. Now here also there are much more varietal classes, or there are also 5 groups are there of varieties, or 10 groups. Especially here we have displayed only 4 groups. We will see these names. Varieties have classified into 5 groups. The first one is Spanish group, the next one is Queen group, the third one is Abaxi groups, the fourth one is Maipuri group. Now let us see about the first group of varieties, that is Spanish group. You can see also difference in the size, color of the fruits. Now in Spanish group, the fruits are 1 to 2 kgs by weight. They are globules in shape, fibrous, subacidic, spiny, and these varieties are resistant to mealybugs. Now, name of the varieties under Spanish group are Mauritius Red Spanish, Singapore Spanish, Green Selangor, and Castilia. And the last one is PR1-67. Now the next group is Queen group. Here you can see the fruits are conical in shape, spiny. They have deep eyes, low in fiber. The weight of the fruit is 0.5 to 1 kg. They are sweet in taste and they have yellow flesh. Here also color of the fruit is orange, yellow to orange. Now the varieties under this group are Queen, MacGregor, Natal, Ripley and Alexandria, and Smooth Shiny. These are the varieties under Queen group. Now Abaxi group. Abaxi group, characters of this Abaxi groups are conical fruits, pale yellow, white flesh, spiny, weight is 1.4 kgs, sweet, tender and juicy. Now these are varieties are grown in Brazil. Now varieties under this group are Parola, Abaca, Sugarloaf, Pepelon, Venezolana and Amarela. Now these are the varieties under Abaxi groups. Now the Maipuri groups, characters of these varieties are fruits are ovoid to cylindrical, sweeter, fibrous, 1 to 2.5 kgs by weight. They have yellow flesh, very juicy varieties. The varieties under Maipuri groups are Maipuri, Bumugusa, Rondon, Perolera, and Monti Lirio. Now these are the varieties under Maipuri groups. Let us move on to the next slides. Cultivars grown commercially in India are Q, Giant Q, Queen, Mauritius. Now these are the varieties or cultivars grown in India for commercial cultivations. Some of the indigenous cultivars are Jaradhoop, it is sweet type of variety, Bhakat in Assam, this is a sour type of variety, Lakhat in Nagaland, and Baruipur local in West Bengal. Now we can see here some of the pictures of the varieties are displayed here, which are grown in India. Mauritius, Giant Q, and Queen. You can see the size differences and also the color differences in these four varieties. Now, let us see the diagrammatic representation of this ananas crop or ananas plant. Diagrammatic representation. At the top of the fruit, you can see a stem, leaves, and also ananas fruit. But at the top of the diagram, you can see the crown of the fruit. Then the fruit itself. Below that fruit, you can see the slips. Also on the stems, there are slips. Then there are long leaves, which have thorn on their outer margin. Now you can see the aerial suckers arising from the axil of the leaves. And at the bottom of the plant, just the collar region, there are ground suckers. And below the ground, you can see the fibrous roots. This diagram is very useful or important in relation to the propagation, because the crown, the slips and the suckers, these are the main parts which are used for vegetative propagation of this ananas. Now let us see about the propagation. Ananas, pineapple is mainly propagated by vegetative methods, that is suckers, slips, crowns and stems. Among these, suckers, slips and crowns are the three important parts majorly used for planting. The suckers arise from the axils of the leaves below the ground level and come to the flowering early, that means 15 to 18 months. Slips formed on the fruit stalk below the fruit are usually preferred for planting. Flower initiation takes place 20 to 20 months after planting, respectively the crowns, then crowns 24 months. That means when suckers arising from the leaf axils are planted or used for planting, flowering takes place within 15 to 18 months. But when slips are below the fruit are used for planting, flowering takes place within 22 months. But when crowns are used for planting, the time required is, that means flowering takes within 24 months. That means the plant part used, the flowering depends upon the plant part used for planting. About 250 to 500 grams weight of sucker should be there for planting. That means these suckers weighing 250 to 500 grams are used for planting. Regarding slips, the weight should be 250 to 450 grams. And regarding crowns, the height is given here. It should be 40 to 45 centimeters. Now, these are the ideal characters for planting materials when used. The planting material should be pre-treated with mercurial fungicides. The planting material should not be stored more than 40 days. That means the planting material should be stored, but it should not be stored for more than 14 days. Suckers production can be enhanced by giving additional nitrogenous fertilizers and more water. That means for where our intentions or aim is to produce suckers for plantation or propagation, more nitrogenous fertilizers and water should be, additional nitrogenous fertilizers and water should be applied to the crop. Nowadays, micro-propagated plants are also available. That means pineapple is also propagated by tissue culture nowadays. Now, regarding the planting is done during kharif season. That means during rainy season. Before planting, suckers or slips should be sun-cured. This is very important. Prior to planting, they should be sun-cured. Dry leaves and scales at the base should be removed. Planting material should be dipped in 0.4% difolton and 0.05% Ecallax to avoid fungal and mealybug infections. That means prior treatment for this planting material is recommended. That means 0.4% difolton and 0.05% Ecallax to avoid fungal and mealybug infestations. The suckers or slips are planted at 10 to 15 centimeter deep holes. While planting, the ground pulp should not be buried. The suckers or slips are planted in 10 to 15 centimeter deep holes. While planting, the growing part, that means the above portion or the tips, should not be buried. They should be kept open. Planting may be done in single row or double row systems. That means on pineapple is planted in single rows or in double rows. In single row systems, we can accommodate about 15,000 to 20,000 plants per hectare and yields about 20 tons per hectare. That means yield depends upon the number of plants per hectare. In double row system, which is also called as high density planting, the planting distance is 25 cm by 35 cm by 90 cm. That is also known as high density planting. It is adopted in almost all pineapple growing regions of India. We can accommodate about 64,000 plants and give about 100 to 120 tons of per hectare of fruit yield. Let me explain this slightly, that the first distance in double row system, 25 cm, is between to plant or sucker to sucker or crown to crown. The next 35 cm distance is between the two rows of the crowns or suckers. And the 90 cm distance is between two beds, whether it may be a flat bed or raised bed, or shallow trenches are also dug for planting these pineapple crowns or slips or suckers. That means the 90 cm distance is kept between two flat beds. Now the type of beds depends upon the season and type of the soil. That means in rainy season, raised beds are preferred, whereas in winter season, flat beds are preferred. Let us move on to the next slide. Here you can see double row system, that is high density planting system, is followed here. You can see here ananas plantation. Now you can see a person planting here the crowns of the ananas and also slips of the ananas. Now here you can see the adjoining ananas plantation field. Now manure and fertilizer requirements. You can see here manure and fertilizer requirement of pineapple. About 30 tons of farmyard manure per hectare per year, along with 500 kgs of nitrogen, 140 kgs of phosphorus and 560 kgs of potassium, NPK per hectare for 42,000 plants per hectare, whereas 600 kgs of nitrogen, 200 kgs of phosphorus and 600 kgs of potassium for 64,000 plants per hectare. Fertilizer should be applied at 3 months after planting in 4 split intervals.
That means fertilizer is applied after 3 months of planting and in 4 split doses. Foliar application of nitrogen, that is 2 to 4% is practiced. Earthing up, this is also most important interculture operation. Earthing should be done after fertilizer application and after harvesting, otherwise lodging will occur. That means to avoid lodging, earthing should be done after fertilizer application and after harvesting. Irrigation, though pineapple is a rain-fed crop, 4 to 6 irrigations may be necessary during dry seasons at 20 to 25 days interval. Weed control, combination spray of Bromocil and Diuron at the rate 2 kg actual ingredient per hectare as pre-emergent herbicides can control weeds efficiently. Now, flowering and fruiting. A pineapple plant generally attains flowering stage at 10 to 12 months after planting, by which time the plant should have produced at least 40 leaves. Irregular flowering behavior is one of its major drawbacks. Flowering is not uniform in pineapple. Now, this is one of the major problems, that there is no uniform flowering in pineapple. Irregular flowering behavior is observed in pineapple. To induce good and uniform flowering in following, the following measures are to be taken, that is spraying of nectarine acetic acid 100 to 200 ppm. Staggered planting to get fruits throughout the year. The plants generally gives out inflorescence in 12 to 13 months after planting, that is February, April. Staggered planting means not planting the whole field at once. You have to plant in small lots so we can receive the fruits throughout the year. Fruit takes about 4.5 to 5.5 months from fruit set to harvest. That means after fruit set, it takes about 5.5 months till harvest, that is June to August. Now, here is a picture displayed about ananas growing fruit in its earlier stages. Now, we will move to the next slide regarding harvesting and yield. At maturity, with a slight color change at the base of the fruit, the lowest eyelids have orange-yellow color and flattened. The bracts becomes loose and brown. Now, these are the indices of maturity in pineapple. The fruit should be harvested along with 5 to 7 centimeter stalk and full maturity, because it is non-climatic fruit. It is a non-climatic fruit. There is slight change at the color change at the base of the fruit, and the lowest eyelids have turned orange yellow color and are flattened. Now, yield is the yield from a plantation of about 35,000 to 45,000 per hectare is about 40 to 50 tons, and that from the plantation of about 43,000 to 50,000 per hectare normally varies between 50 to 60 tons. Now, ripening, pre-harvest application of ethereal at 500 ppm induces uniform ripening and color development, but fruits will be acidic and lack flavor. Now, this is found important, ethereal treatment, but the fruits turn acidic and lack the flavor. Now, physiological disorders observed in pineapple are sunscald, fasciation and multiple crowns, and black heart. Let us see the first disorder. Sunscald. The cells under the fruit skin of exposed surface to sun rays get damaged. Care should be taken to control lodging, and fruit should be covered with draw straw or its own leaves during April-May. Now, during these months, that is April-May, it is very necessary to control the lodging and to cover the fruits with draw straw or its own leaves, because to avoid that exposure of the fruit skin to direct sun rays. Fasciation and multiple crowns. Now, multiple crown may occur due to genetical factor as well as due to soil and environmental reasons. It is also due to excess nitrogen. Fruits gets flattened and fascinated in fertile virgin soil of warm areas. More abnormal fruits occur as compared to less fertile soils. Now, this is a problem in fertile virgin soils and of warm areas. More abnormal fruits are found where multiple crowns occur due to, it may be a genetical factor also, or due to soil and environmental conditions. Now, the next physiological disorder is black heart. It is also known as endogenous brown spot or internal browning. Formation of brown spot at the base of the fruitlets and further black discoloration of the center of the core. Now, these are the symptoms, that is, the brown spots are observed at the base of the fruitlets and
black discoloration at the center of the core. Low temperature or exogenous application of gibberellic acid can induce disorder. Now these are the reasons: low temperature and application of gibberellic acid. Fruits exposed to high temperature, that is 40 degrees centigrade for 24 hours, reduces black heart in cold stored pineapples. Now when the fruits get exposed to 40 degrees centigrade for 24 hours, this reduces the black heart disorder in cold stored pineapples. Now this is for pineapple cultivation today. We have completed the pineapple cultivation practices today. So let us stop here, students. Thank you all of you.